Looking at sheet music can be overwhelming as a non-music reader. But we've got some quick tips that will help demystify music notation for even the most novice of beginners. Let's talk about how printed music is organized. See these groups of five horizontal lines? That's called a staff, or in multiple, staves. Because they're connected here on the left with this vertical line, we know that each of these staves has musical material that's intended to be performed at the same time. These vertical lines mark measures, a way of breaking up music into shorter chunks. Here we have measure 1, 2, 3, and 4. Music directors often use measure numbers as a way for everyone to know which part of the music is being discussed or where to begin singing during a rehearsal. We read music from left to right, like a book, and also like a book, when we run out of space at the end of the line, we move down and back to the left. But how do you know what to sing? The easiest way to know which staff has your vocal line is to look for lyrics. But it's also good to know that most theater music starts at the bottom of the system with the piano accompaniment, one staff each for the pianist's left and right hand, with the vocal line, or sometimes multiple vocal lines, above that. Sometimes you'll encounter music that has additional staffs on top of the piano part that indicate other material in the accompaniment. The vocal parts will almost always be topmost staffs in the system. Other times, especially when rehearsing a musical, you might be given music that has only a vocal line. There are two kinds of symbols that you most likely see in your vocal line: notes and rests. Notes are materials that should be performed, while rests indicate silence. Notes all have circular note heads, often with stems extending from them. Here's several types of notes you're likely to see. Rests have a more varied appearance. Here are several types of rest you're likely to see. When following along, imagine a line traveling from left to right at a consistent speed. When it reaches a note, that's when it should be performed. Another way of thinking about it is notes that are closer to each other horizontally are performed faster than notes that have wide spaces between them. As for pitches, the higher a note is placed on the staff, the higher the pitch, and vice versa. Go.